Hey everyone, and thanks for watching 3dmotive.com. My name is Cordell Felix, and on this video I will show you how to get text tessellated and ready to be turbosmooth using a couple tricks using the Proboolean modifier advanced options. I will be using 3ds Max 2013 for this quick tip, and this video assumes that you have a basic knowledge of 3ds Max and its interface. This technique is nice for getting text evenly divided and gives you a nice surface to sculpt on in ZBrush. You could also use this technique to get some extra high poly detail for a model. I use it a lot for getting spline shapes ready for ZBrush. This technique could be used on any spline shape. I used it for car logos that I created with splines and then applied these couple steps and then got it ready for ZBrush. Let's start by creating some text. You can create text by going to the Create tab and then going to Shapes and then click Text once. Then you can click on the screen and there is the text. You can edit the text by going to this text box right here and typing whatever you want. For this tutorial's sake, I'm going to have 3dmotive. Once you have the text there, I'm going to right-click and turn it into editable poly, so now it is no more a spline. Once you have that, you're going to want to shell it. And I have the amount for the outer to be 5, and then the segments to be 2. I have the segments at 2 because I want all the quads to be even. That way, it doesn't get stretched out. If it's at 1, and you turbo smooth, it's going to get stretched out and it's not going to look very nice and you won't be able to sculpt it very well if you put this in ZBrush. So I'm going to leave the segments at 2. Oh, and also the shell modifier, you can go under here and just type in SH, which will bring you straight to shell, and just click shell and it will add onto that. I have 2 of them on here, so it's going to look like that. But their end results should go to that. Now this next part is a little tricky. We're going to be adding in a shape and then pro-booleaning it out without the new mesh actually intersecting with the text. And we do this because we want to use one of the advanced options in the pro-boolean settings, which makes everything's all the n-gons to be quadrilateral. It'll be evenly spaced so that when turbo smooth, the corners will be nice and round, and everything should be a nice surface to use inside of ZBrush. So to start, I'm going to just add in whatever shape I want. And you could do that by going to the standard primitives, and I'm just going to create a box for this, nice and simple, and make sure it's not intersecting with the text. So now with the text, you need to add the Proboolean, and if you can do that by going to this drop-down and then go to Compound Objects and click Proboolean. Now with the Proboolean on there, let's start picking and make sure it's on Move and Subtraction. If you click the box, it should go away, and then even your shell's subdivision should go away, or the segment, sorry. But that's okay because it's still going to be using that information to calculate how the mesh is going to be evenly subdivided. It just doesn't show. Now we're going to go to the advanced options. Under the advanced options, there's going to be a mate quadrilaterals, and I'm going to set this to the quad size to be 0.4% first, and then mate quadrilaterals. And this will basically tessellate the mesh very evenly, and we'll get it ready to be tessellated. You can mess with the size of the quad size percent if you want to. Like if I go to 3, it'll be kind of big. Go to 1, pretty reasonable. I'm just going to use 0.4 because that's the setting I usually have. And I'm going to right-click, convert to editable poly for good measure so that everything is collapsed and it's good to go. Let's check out the model now by going in and looking at the quads. It's got some dirty looking quads. I see some triangles in there and some uneven quads that aren't completely orthogonal. But that doesn't really matter because most of the outside, they are quads and the triangles are in the inside. And if you do add a Turbosmooth modifier on there, it should subdivide pretty nicely. So I'm going to go ahead and click Turbosmooth. You can go to the modifier tab, type in TU and click Turbosmooth. And let's do 2 iterations. And I'll throw on nicely in display for fun. I'm going to hit F4 now and get rid of the wireframe to check out the corners and everything, make sure it's all good. And it seemed to be turbo smooth just as I wanted. The corners are nice and round, and it looks very smooth and turbo smooth perfectly. And that's pretty much all you need to do to get tessellated text that you can throw a turbo smooth modifier on and get all the text to be equally subdivided. I wanted to note that you can change your font in the text underneath the parameters. So when you create the text, you can go to this parameter and change the font to whatever you want. And also, if you don't like the thickness or how tight the edges are here, whenever you go to the quad percent size under the Proboolean settings, you can set the percent to be a little bigger. Mine was at 0.4. If you set it to like 1, this edge will be a lot larger. So it all depends on what setting you have. That's it for this quick tip. My name is Cordell Felix, and thanks again for watching 3dmotive.com.